Welcome to tonight's little correction, as I like to call it.
Meow.
This is where I actually forgot to upload this video in particularly. So I'll be doing it from here on out and trying to correct myself as well as time goes on. Hopefully you guys can forgive me if I talk a little bit funny in this video. So let's not waste too much time. Get to it.
So, ladies and gentlemen, sound effects. I don't usually like the guy. Once in a while, I'll watch him. Sometimes I'll see the stream. Sometimes I don't. And even if I do watch him, I'm either playing another game like this or doing something else. Yeah.
So, yeah, that is definitely true. I'm sorry, unlike most of the people in this community, I don't sit there and watch LTG like the old days. I kind of actually play something else while watching them. More likely, you can say I listen to it like a podcast rather than it being paid attention to now. Because once I start to realize and I have, you know, the materials in my hands, my PS4 in my hands, I start to realize that I gotta start thinking about actually doing things based on myself and not doing things based on others. So I'm not gonna sit here and be obsessed and say, oh, I hate LTG, and comment and make thousands of channels, thousands of fake burner accounts to comment and say some crap. Like, I'm not gonna do that. Not all the time. Not ever again either.
Something about Coryxkenshin. That's the first thing that gets me up and riled about. The fact that I heard about Coryxkenshin out of all people, I'm like, damn, I didn't think that nigga out of all people would be his target.
Excuse my friends if I say that word. And yes, that is definitely true. He does not like his own people. See, there's a difference between actually talking about what's the problems in the black community and what's like everything is bad about them type of crap. You know what I'm saying? Like, oh my god, I hate being around my own people. Because they did this to me. They did that to me. If that's such a problem, right? If that's such a problem, it might mean there's something more likely the issue with you rather than it being them. Experience or not, if you're going to hold on to that to your entire race, that's something that's weird about you. Because you're sitting there hating on your own people. Hating on people who get more money than you. Or more famous than you. Or more popular than you. And you're sitting there discussing why I don't have 100k subs. I don't have this. I'm going to get to that part here in this video. But the reason why your own people probably don't like you is because they see something in you. Some people see something in you and sense it too. It's not like it's a superpower, but it's damn sure something to be like, damn, I don't like this person for a reason. There's something about him that makes me uncomfortable.
I don't know what he means by he's not hating when he's actually literally derogatorily bullying them. To goddamn hell. And the fact that LTG really acts like he cares and wants to be nice about it, let me make something clear to you. All of us, or well, trolls, I guess I could say I'm sort of neutral because I'm not doing a lot for the troll community.
And that's true, I am sort of neutral probably in there. I guess I can say I am sort of neutral. That I'm someone who's kind of like there, but not really, because I'm doing monthly clips rather than it being a daily clip. You see what I'm saying? Like, people wouldn't like that. They wouldn't like me be doing, like, monthly clips. So that's why I get the lowest possible, and when I mean possible views, I probably get the lowest out of all of them because people don't like it when I'm not doing a daily type of thing. Or at least a compilation. One thing's for sure, people definitely came to this channel for compilations, but I stopped doing it because there's too much lag. My program stopped working, shuts down, does the same thing, shuts down. He says I can't do anymore, not responding. But that all is going to stop. I'm telling you right now, that's going to stop very soon. And I will get back to compilations, but for now you gotta bear with me. Now I want to discuss the other half that I just talked about. Because there are two sides in, well, actually three, if I like to say it that way. There are three sides in the black community. There is the hoodlums, and then there are the Uncle Ruckuses. The hoodlums believe that they are oppressed and that everything is going horribly wrong for them and life is just not fair and all this because we don't get this much of reparations or some crap like that. And the Uncle Ruckuses are the ones who always want to attack their own mirror image every damn time. Now, there's the normal black man, me being one of them. I'm a centerist or centrist. I see both wrong and I can see both right. But I damn sure see both sides wrong as hell. Because both of them were equally hateful towards something. So we'll continue off with that.
As everyone always states that I am a clout chaser. Also another quote.
Which, yes, that is now being currently addressed and I just uploaded that video. Go check it out, because it's addressing those people who kept making those same comments over and over again. Note that I'm the only troll channel that deals with this. Now, as I stated before, I was inspired by one in particular troll from a different community that is not the LTG community. That troll made a separate account from his main account. So then I was like, okay, that's a good idea. But if I wanted to, realistically, I couldn't have just been like someone who didn't have a main channel for myself and just sat there and go into the Discord and talk smack about LTG and be like, I hate LTG. I hate him so much. I hope he dies. I hope he gets run over a car. Like, I'm sorry. I don't wake up in the morning, as stated before in this video right now, that I'm about to say the exact same thing I'm about to say right now in this video, is that I don't wake up in the morning or 6 a.m. in the morning just to talk smack about LTG and say how much I hate him and how much this. At this point, I'm not going to lie with you guys. I'm more likely entertained than anything. I see this man as a clown, not someone as an enemy or a rival. This man is someone who I consider as a clown. Someone who I'm not even going to be upset over. I'm laughing. And he's right. He is entertaining because of the rage and quit. That's it.
Quote that I like to take in a note over the years. And which I don't really care about trolling, as they would say. And honestly, let me make something clear to you guys. I don't wake up thinking about this man on a daily basis. I made that on my troll account to make it clear to a portion of y'all trolls that I don't like think about this dude. I don't wake up to LTG clips. I don't wake up to think about LTG. I don't know where he gets this mindset of people waking up to thinking about him, but no one thinks about him.
Sadly, one Discord does wake up and think about him. I'm not gonna point you out, but you were that one Discord that literally wakes up to talk about him at 6 a.m. to God knows when. Where's the ape at? Where's the monkey at? Type of racist bullcrap that I keep seeing on there.
But what I can't stand more is my own people, right? My own people hating on someone else of my own descent for something they have that's positive. Look at LTG's content and look at...
And again, yeah, look at his content. All of that is just a desperate clout chasing rush, as I like to call it, where you try to jump on the most trendiest topic ever, and he's trying to jump on topics that are profiting off of other people's misfortune when no one asks for his thoughts on any of it, by the way. No one asks for those, except those people, those children asked to know about his opinion, I guess. Those people who believe he is a guru, someone who can give advice to people. But sadly, these people are not smart, so it's understandable. The blind cannot hear, and the blind cannot see, but they choose to hear what they want to see. So yeah.
Coryxkenshin. That dude's content is 10 times better. Sure, to me, he's a bit on the cringy side, and then a bit on the funny side. I feel like he's more funny than cringy. There's a reason why you won't be popular, my nigga. Again, I apologize for my French of using the M word, but let me make something clear to you. The reason why you are never going to be popular is not because of the trolls, it's because of your content and how you handle things.
It really is his content and how he handled things, though. I'm sorry, it really is. Like, when you're desperate, you guys, human beings can sense it. Especially when it's on the media. You can sense the desperation from the screen. He already openly admitted that he was doing this content for clout chasing purposes, but without saying that he was clout chasing. Do you know what I'm coming from, bro? That's what I'm talking about. This guy openly admitted to clout chasing without saying that I'm clout chasing. Like, he will do anything for money. And a man that does anything for money is someone who is a danger to himself. The only way how you get money is by controlling it and not allowing the money to control you. But he's controlled by the money because he thinks doing the content that he's currently doing is going to get him somewhere. It's not. Trust me. You'll be stuck where you're at for a cool minute. Okay? Not to be rude, but let's move on.
People don't like a boring, angry man who gets mad at everybody for something that they don't even do. People are literally minding their own business while you're hating on them.
And that's true. Smug. A whole bunch of other people, but all of them have a very good pattern of why he hates on them. Each of them is black. I will tell you that much right now. Each of them are black people. And he really sees himself as an entertaining person. You're entertaining by rage quitting. Like, I've watched his content before to see what is so entertaining. I want to see what's so entertaining, and I watch, and I watch, and there's nothing entertaining. All he's talking about is all these topics that a bunch of other people are already on top of. Remember, there's competition in the YouTube algorithm. You cannot compete with other people who are bigger than you, especially if they're like doing it on a daily basis. This man just started, and he thinks the reason why he should be getting a 100k subs is because his quote unquote talented Skittles is going to save him, and that he is a way better content creator than everyone else. What in God's name possessed this man to say that is what's confusing me, bro. My guy, you were never better than almost everyone else. Your content is boring, except when it's rage and quit. That's why the trolls all combined in views and subscribers are actually way bigger than him. There's a troll currently that has 10k subs and another one that might have been at a... When I say this 100k subs, maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I was just seeing things, but I swear to God, there are trolls with higher views than him. Joshua Cornstar literally got 700k. And you're gonna tell me that his content's trash? Bro, his content not trash. I'm sorry. And he's a troll. The haters are apparently winning more than the person that should be supported is winning at all. He's still losing a mile.
I don't believe any of your apologies because most of it's fake crap. And everyone who really believes in that, well, I forgot, you're a Covenant fan, so really you'll believe anything he says. He can say, I'm sorry I killed a baby, and you guys would be like, you know, he didn't do anything wrong, he killed a baby though. I literally think of his fan base like that. His fan base are actually worse. They dox people, you know, all the typical crap that you expect from their fan base. But that's not the point here. We're talking about the fact that he hated on Coryxkenshin. Coryxkenshin doesn't give a damn, clearly, but I'm just saying, listen, my guy, do yourself a really big solid and stop thinking about what Coryxkenshin has done. You're a grown man thinking about someone who has 10 million subs.
But yeah, his fans do have a habit of doxing people, even in that little Discord of theirs. Sometimes I see little things, little snippets of something that shouldn't even be there, but it is. Now, him and that excuse that I said earlier, if he killed a baby, he would just be like, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to. People would take his apology like it was nothing. Especially, well, it's not people, it's probably them because they're blinded. Remember, they believe that LTG is someone who can help them with their relationship advice. I discussed this in today's video. The people there think that he can help save these people from doing something, or someone even said that they were stopping to commit suicide because of LTG and because he helped them out in some sort of way. I find that bullcrap, but you know, some people like to say things to make LTG respond, if you know what I mean. Not because they want to say it so they can actually praise LTG, they more likely just say it so LTG can respond and it gives them a type of arousement for him to respond, and particularly us, it's nothing, it's more of a laugh. Them, it's just like, oh my god. He responded. Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god, oh my god, he responded. And he's thanking me too. Like, a Covenant, man. Seriously. Big fight after a stream a long time ago. They had a huge argument on stream about their future children, their future kids. I suggest you go watch that video. I will link it in the description. There was only one troll who has it left. LTG was pretty much simped out, as I like to call it. Like, you couldn't really fight her too much on it. But many sides actually argued, including the trolls, which was a very interesting video to see from other people. Some of the, I guess, Covenant and trolls were fighting each other. Even some of the trolls agreed with LTG, and some of the trolls agreed with Alaina. Some of the Covenant members agreed with Alaina, and then some of the Covenant members even agreed with LTG. So it was kind of a back and forth fight between both sides, or more likely I can say four. It was an X-shaped type of battle, or battle royale as I like to call it. Like, everyone was against each other, all their beliefs and this and that. Yeah. Anyways, let me continue this.
Channel, unless if you're here to troll. Let me tell you why also trolling LTG is the only content you can really do. You can't really enjoy it because you look at the content, right? Unlike most trolls, I know what's up and what he's doing. More likely, not what he's doing, I know what his fan base is doing. See, his fan base is smart. Sure, they're dumb when it comes to conversations and trying to roast each other, but they're smart. You see, the trolls don't see this, but the fans are trying to bring in content for LTG.
And that's goddamn right. That's why they're trying to bring in content. They won't allow him to actually think of something up. Apparently, they're trying to bring in things that they don't need to bring in. Like, about half of these topics don't even make any sense. They're not even topics at this point. They're just blatant clout chasing videos. You might as well just put clout chaser on every single thumbnail and make it look like that. Because these fans, they really think that doing this is going to help him. He's not even barely scratching the surface at all like that. Like, someone at his level is at least getting 22k views, or 16 views, or 15 views, or 14 views, or something like that. Even worse. But you know what I mean. Like, it keeps going lower. Like, it sometimes goes to above the threshold, and sometimes it goes below the threshold. Like, it's a back and forth pattern. The largest threshold he can get is at least 66k views. The lowest is usually when it hits like 5k, something like that. That's as far as he goes sometimes.
Maybe this might have been obvious to some of you guys, but the fact that you're trying to bring content to this loser just shows that he is burnt out of content and he can barely do anything by himself.
And he, yeah, he barely can. I'm not gonna lie with you, he barely can. He barely can actually do anything at all, let alone actually think of something to watch. People literally had to send him videos of this and that, and then he'll make a topic on it. And you know what's funny? Again, the idiot's not realizing there's more competition than him. And most of the time, these are cases of drama that he's profiting off of. Like, there was a recent one in his little area of the town where some father did some horrible thing on Christmas or something like that. You can go watch that trash, but I'm not gonna link it for you. I know what I'm talking about. So, he's really trying to reach for content that he'll never get to. Like, there's too many competition for it. Like, how many times do I have to say it? The guy's never going to get there. He's going to be on a very, very slow, hard ride. The only people who are coming to LTG's channel are people who are just here to watch him fail. That's all I gotta say. DSP and freaking Wings of Redemption have more subs. Like, goddamn, man. At least they're honorable to their craft, as I like to call it, I guess.
get it. Before someone goes, oh, but you're someone with 337 subs.
What someone will try to do.
You're gonna be talking. First of all, I can be talking every damn time.
Damn right. Just as he name drops people, I can be talking about him too. That's a thing, that's a problem with certain people. Just because you name drop someone else's name, right? And they're somehow, it's one-sided, right? That's what's so funny about these types of people. It's one-sided. So, say for example, you name drop on, let's make up a random content creator that isn't real. A guy named Blue Blood or something like that. Blue Blood X9. And Blue Blood X9 is some douchebag who isn't just raging. Raging is nothing, right? Raging is just a part of someone getting upset at the game. Forget all the raging. This guy's a complete douchebag. He doxes his fan base. He doxes other people. And then someone makes a video on him. And then Blue Blood X9, little fan base, little twerps, decide to come over and say that you're clout chasing, seething, and freaking trying to get attention. But yet when Blue Blood X9 does the video, he's completely safe from it. He's not clout chasing when he's talking about someone else and name dropping them. See the exact hypocritical type of thing I'm talking about? That's what I'm talking about right there, man. Is that super hypocritical? You can't just be like one-sided and say, you can't do this, but I can do that. That's not how it works.
I can be saying things every damn time. I don't care how big of a platform it is. If I get 7 views, I get 7 views.
Exactly right.
I'm not afraid to have small amount of views. In fact, recently one of my shorts got like 473. To me, that's great. I always feel thankful for when I get even a small portion. I like when I'm putting out content. I'm not trying to feel like I really don't care about it. I like putting out content. So when I have this I don't care attitude with everything, I'll just completely go berserk. I've been going berserk all this weekend.
And you know, I'm actually planning on doing more shorts for this channel, as this type of thing is actually providing a perfect way how to get into the algorithm. Shorts is probably the most useful. When I say this, guys, please, if you're a content creator, small content creator, please use the Shorts app immediately. Well, Shorts app. Please use the Shorts. God damn it. You know what I mean? Just use the Shorts. I keep saying the Shorts. It sounds so weird. Just Shorts are like small videos or small second videos where you post it, whatever it is, and that's it.
Videos out. I got a new Flash video.
Yep.
You know, Orbital Decay. I hope definitely you guys enjoy that video. I hope that's something that you guys remember back in your childhood.
Man's be asking donations every millisecond or else he's done. Remember those days where he would, oh my god, 2019. Does everyone remember those days where his Twitch got banned beforehand and he would ask for money or else he would be like leaving the stream? And if no one donated within the following hour, you would just cut it off. Damn times, man. And even that was lasting until 2020. It was so funny. And his fans would immediately panic, bro. His fans would immediately panic trying to get their mom and dad's credit card. It was hilarious. They were like, oh my god, where's my mom's credit card? I bet they were like, Sally, where's my mom's credit card? She left it in her drawer. Why do you want it? I just need it. And Sally gives the credit card. She'll be like, you're gonna get in trouble again if you're donating to that grown man, by the way. Shut up and get the hell out of my room. He donates a whole bunch of $100 or something like that down the drain. Oh my god. Like, you can hear from a mile away. Some of these people are hella weird, man. They were bomb rushed from that. I remember those days. And yeah, he probably is in his 40s. Remember, his advice could possibly only be for the ones in the 40s line or 30s. That's where it probably isn't a scam. So, I'm sorry that this turned into a whole fiasco of me talking smack, but I just wanted to lay it down. There will be a bunch of chapters. I'll try to shorten it as much as I can.
Well, okay. Hold on. Maybe at least 39 or 38. But for starters, the reason why I say 38 on someone that is positive. Mr. Double Tooth or something like that.
And he does have a double tooth. I just showed that into today's video's thumbnail. Yeah. Another tooth on top of another tooth. That's pretty bad. He gotta fix that grill real quick. Like, make that 2022's resolution. Fix LTG's grill. Cause that... No, that thing's been there for a cool minute. That's not good. I think that might be more of a cancer. I could be wrong. Or a disease. There's no goddamn way. How do you have that thing for that long? That thing should have fell out the way how it's placed, you guys. It looks hella weird and uncomfortable looking at it. He should have closed his mouth when doing the video. That's how gross that is.
This clear, anyone really hating on Coryxkenshin? I mean, well, it is your opinion and to your right. But my point is, if you're LTG, for example, the exact same man saying that hating on black people, coons and all this, calling other people coons.
Which he has no right to be even using that word when him alone is the only one who is exactly that. You act. And when I say this, you act like one. So that's why anyone who's hating on their people like you do and has a strong hatred for people, I guess, in what's that area? I'm not even gonna say where he lives, but wherever that area is, you need to let it go. It happened there. Not all black people are like that. If that's your issue, then that's on you. And if you want to stay that way, then that's on you. I don't know what else to say.
He does not like his own people and wants to either be white or Mexican or another color, and always will berate his own people, thus meaning you, because
and true. And that was a kind of good definition. It's more of insecurities than anything and self-hatred towards himself.
What do? You berate your own people all the damn time. I don't understand that. I know many people are like, why does this video exist? Who cares? Coryxkenshin doesn't care? I mean, yeah, of course. I know. Coryxkenshin doesn't.
And probably people are going to ask why it exists, so that's why I was thinking realistically. The video exists only because of the fact that I was disappointed in Coryxkenshin for bowing and taking the knee by literally going green when he can just straight up called LTG out and be like, hey man, that's not cool, bro. I'm not any of those words that you just called me. I'm sorry that I used a sound bit of yours, but it's not that serious. You don't have to go around calling me a coon or anything like that. So let's move on.
What I damn sure am trying to say is that this man is not someone to be judging anyone when
he really isn't, when he has so many flaws. Like, I'm not even gonna lie, too many flaws for me to even point out. Next,
many people should be judging you for what you've been doing,
and we're gonna skip some of these because I feel like I'm repeating over myself. So yes, congratulations, you honestly got me to admit it, so I praise you for it.
Locked everything. He didn't even, the stupid little kid paid $20 for it. And guess what? I will say that. He scammed a miner out of a Smash lobby.
And he did scam a miner out of a Smash lobby, but not related to Coryxkenshin.
Not drama. I just hope he just ignores it like it's nobody's business.
Which he did not ignore it. Because unfortunately one day he actually paid money towards LTG. Literally and figuratively, he paid money towards LTG. Went green, apologized, and literally got on his knees. Another grown man got on his knees and bowed down to LTG and literally said, "I'm sorry, didn't know it was your voice." I'm sorry to him as well. That is not professional. Professionally, you should have stood up for yourself and said that was not cool, as I said before. But choices were made, weren't they, Corey?
Guy literally goes on Twitter every day.
He does.
Every day, if I recall.
And harasses a bunch of women, saying that you're not cute, trying to have a competition with them, and literally say that you're body looks fake, something like that. Some corny mess. And most of the women block him and move forward with their lives while he's sitting there bent out of shape thinking about him.
And literally gets mad.
He considers himself straight, but yet he's trying to compete with other women. Does anyone notice that? Why is he trying to compete with other women by like going on their pages and saying that you're not cute? If I recall, most gay men do that. And that's what most gay men do, is that they'll be like, "You're not cute. You look ugly." Like, that's something a female would do. If you're like a jealous girl, of course.
I'd add, any woman he can find that's showing a little bit of some explicit content.
And true, yeah.
That shouldn't be around, you know. Be talking all that smack like a female.
Let's keep that note in mind.
Recall this, because out of respect for every girl, even though I don't like thoughts in general, I don't.
And I don't, because you're alluring men that don't know anything any better. But after a while, I just started to ignore your existence, and that's like, you don't exist. So I made it simpler for myself. By not acknowledging you, I'm not giving you any power. But by acknowledging you, I'm giving you some sort of power. Some sort of fragments of understanding that I am watching you.
My thoughts. But you see, the smart thing about most people is that they ignore that type of explicit content.
They do, but there is a fat portion that doesn't and thinks that they will get with that woman, or maybe I shouldn't just say women because it could be men too, with that type of person. So they'll simp all day and think they'll get somewhere. You guys know how this works.
Except simps. But I do think LTG is low-key a simp because he keeps on watching.
And that is true. I do think he's low-key a simp. Why would you sit there on a daily basis? That's why, guys, his current Twitter is probably banned because of that. He probably made an alternative account just to bother some other woman for no damn reason at all. Jesus, it's almost an hour. Yeah, let's keep going.
These girls, sometimes he would be like looking up 16, and sometimes these people are in their teens.
I'm not gonna lie about that one, you guys. I'm really gonna tell you the truth. I've caught him like looking up like 16-year-old girls that were on like freaking Twitter, This girl in particular, I can't remember her name, but I know for a fact that she was a teenager. And this dude says, "You're not cute at all. Delete the pic. You have all this blubber all over your arms," or something like that. Some sort of insult. How about that? Just to explain what I mean. And the dude literally started harassing this teenage girl for, God, like, at least 6 replies came up, if I recall. But you see, you guys noticed on Twitter he stopped that.
It's to, like, young college students talking shit about them, and like, okay, like, why do you care? Let them do their own thing. I mean, I don't care about them. I just block them and move forward.
And that's true. I just block them and move forward. I'm not sitting here thinking about why they're doing this exploitative content. If they're doing it and if they're grinding for their money, it's whatever anymore. What's the point of getting upset? Maybe he needs to figure out something about his life.
Or, I don't like that negative content, so I stay away from it. The only reason why you should once again watch LTG is because of the rage clips.
But who the hell cares about that?
I'm not doing that again.
So, now that video has ended. Whew, God. Let's just pause it right here and leave it right here. Now, I wish I did not. Here's where I'm gonna admit myself to this. I wish I did not go into a tangent of talking about LTG when it should have been about goddamn Coryxkenshin. So we're gonna split this off now and make it real quick and summarize it. Coryxkenshin, I'm very disappointed in you because of what you did. You literally went out with a guy who literally called you all these names that didn't need to happen. You allowed it. And on top of that, you paid money for it. Just to prove that you were not a bad guy. Now, if you waste your money on that, that's on you. I will still love your content regardless. But let's not ever talk about LTG ever. Okay? You are one of the first and only nice guy gamers I've ever liked in history. Besides Markiplier, but Markiplier is an old shrewd now, and I don't care about him anymore. The point is that I'm done with only hating content creators. Now, do you subscribe to him? Go ahead and do it, but don't talk to me about him in a positive light ever. Or else I will literally roast you half to death. Okay? Mentally, I mean. Roast you half to death mentally by telling you how stupid you are for thinking that he's a good person. And yes, you can ban me totally in your stream chats too while you're at it. Because you don't know this guy. I've been there to see all the horrible things he's done. So, I'm sorry, you guys. I apologize for me going off on a tangent and taking too long to just make it make sense. So, in summary, content creators out there that I love, I will always support you. But if you talk about him, I'm going to roast you. Have a good one, guys.
Hi, I'm Lucy Christian. I am the voice of Otako Uraraka. And you should subscribe to Neusxanity's channel. Peace out!